More news overseas. Unrest is brewing in China amid its deepening property sector downturn. Chinese asset manager Zhongji Enterprise Group says it will conduct a debt restructuring to stem a liquidity crisis. Zhongji, which has a sizable exposure to real estate, told investors Wednesday it has stopped payment to investors in all investment products. The meeting between management and investors came after its unit, Zhongrong International Trust, missed payments on dozens of investment products. Eyewitness footage showed anxious investors protesting outside Zhongrong Trust's building in Beijing, demanding for the return of their money. One analyst warns liquidity issues stemming from China's real estate sector's cash flow problems could possibly set off a spillover effect to multiple sectors in the country's economy.
As long as the problem in the cash flow of developers are not solved, it's possible to see more credit events like this here and there across the shadow banking sector. So I think in general, it means that investors are likely to be more risk adverse, which doesn't really serve too well for the goal to actually help developers.
The Philippine Central Bank also commits to keeping a market-determined exchange rate. Deputy Governor Francisco Dakila made that remark amid concerns over a depreciating peso. The local currency on Monday hit its weakest level against the greenback since November on the back of worries over China's economic growth and more rate hikes from the Fed. It also lost ground today, Thursday, closing 0.2% lower at 56.77. Dakila says the BSP has the option to intervene when needed.
We remain supportive of a market-determined exchange rate. And this is the best framework that allows us to concentrate on the achievement of our inflation target. The BSP retains the option to go and intervene in the foreign exchange market should market conditions warrant it.
Here are some stocks to watch out for. Monitoring shares of Tyson Foods, which is reportedly planning to sell its China poultry business. Shares of the American meat and processed food maker are down 0.3% in pre-market trade. Also in focus, shares of computer networking giant Cisco Systems. The company posted fiscal fourth quarter earnings that beat Wall Street's expectations. Shares of Cisco are up 2.3% before the bell. We're also keeping a close watch on Adyen's shares, rather. The Dutch payments processor missed analysts' estimates and its own targets for its first half earnings. Shares of Adyen are sharply lower, plunging about 27%.
Let's check on European markets first. They are lower as investors digested the Fed minutes, which showed more rate hikes could be ahead. London's FTSE 100 is down 0.1%, while the German DAX and the French CAC 40 are both flat, but in negative territory. As for Wall Street, futures are getting a lift from retail giant Walmart, which reported earnings and revenue that beat estimates. The company also raised its full-year guidance. Asian markets ended Thursday trade mostly lower following the Fed minutes. Japan's Nikkei 225 fell nearly 0.5% after its trade balance swung into a deficit in July. Australia's ASX 200 saw bigger losses as the country reported unemployment rate rose slightly last month. The Shanghai Composite, meanwhile, picked up 0.4% following the statement of China's premier that the government will work to achieve growth targets this year. Here at home, Philippine shares joined the regional slide, with the main index shedding 0.7%. PhilSocks Financial's Japet Tantianco says the BSP pause was widely expected, but the market was hoping to hear more.
The dovish stance that many were hoping for were not heard today, and that might add to the negative pressures to the local bourse.